Hello, my friends. Welcome. You are finding me here in this corner, which is extremely in the shadow. And I've shown you recently how to vegetalize this type of wall, thanks to the ivy. Today, I will be talking about the cabling of your lights on the bicycle with a lightning which is fed by a dynamo. Usually the dynamo classically are on the side and they are fed by the rotation on the wheel of the bicycle. Here I will be using a dynamo which is within the wheel. This is by far more reliable and is really producing a great energy. So the main purpose is that you have always energy for feeding your lights. You're not at all dependent of the goodwill of your battery or of your charged light. And the second advantage is that you are ceasing of buying once in the year a new one, which is not because the old one wasn't working or because it had been stolen. And this is a further advantage of having a dynamo fed lightning system on the bicycle, is that they are usually not getting stolen. For the lightning, here this is the front light. The cable is already ready to place. Then we have the light for the back. And I think, by the way, both of these lights are very good because they have condensators, which means that you will be able to have light even though you are not cycling. Then we need also a bit of wires. And for the end, we need these plastic hose clamps for attaching the wire. Very important on this model, you have to put the connectors on the left side of the bicycle. Then we'll attach a wire going to the first lamp, which I will change. And from this lamp, I will then bring a cable to the back, let's say around here, for reaching then the back end. Cables, there is one side with a little white stripe and the other side is totally black. And the white stripe, this is for the, let's say, the earth or the mass, and the other side is for the phase, it's where the power is coming from. So this here is a very important little piece. This is a connector to the source of energy. And you see here, this is for the mass. So we'll put the cable with the white in this part. So let's go. I've turned the wire around here. I'm making it very thin. And now we're putting this on the top. And as I said, this little symbol is the mass, so this is for the white. Okay. Then we put the little head like this, and then you plug it into this part. And now we're checking if the front light is working. Yes. So you see here the symbols. This here is the mass, and this is the phase, the plus. So we'll keep the same color code. We'll put the mass with this little white cable. And for putting it, you just put the cable, the wire inside, like this. And then you turn it up like this. Same for the other side. Wires. So we're putting the wires, the color code, the white with the mass, and the black with the plus. So for the cabling, careful to keep a little bit of margin, because as this part is moving, you need a little margin. So let's make a test run. Finally, I'll be needing more length because I have to make sure that there is enough margin when turning the front wheel. A little hint on these ones, if it's too short, you can put them together like this. Fixing the wire beneath the frame, careful of not blocking the cables for the brakes. Cutting the excessive parts of the hose clamps. Here, I'm putting the wire below the porte-bagage. So in case I'm putting things on it, I won't disturb the wire.